Welcome to the session. I am Mr.P.Y.Kumbhar. Today we want to see lossless compression algorithm. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of Shannon-Fano algorithm in multimedia communication techniques. The contents of these topics are introduction, basics of information theory, variable length coding, Shannon-Fano algorithm, compression ratio and entropy. First, introduction. This is a basic diagram of a general data compression scheme. In this diagram, there are mainly three parts. The first one is encoder, second one is storage or network, and third one is decoder. Here, first input data is provided to the encoder. This encoder is also called as a compression. Here, the compression of data will be done. And after that one, it will provide to the networks where will be the stored. After that one, it will send to the decoder. Decoder is also called decompression. Here, the decompression takes place and we get the output data. From this diagram, we can conclude there are two types. One is a lossless data compression and second one is lossy data compression. Now, data compression, also known as source coding. Data compression is the process of encoding data in such a way that it consumes less memory space. Data compression reduces the number of resources required to store and transmit the data. It can be done in two ways, that is lossless compression and lossy compression. Compression means the process of coding that will effectively reduce the total number of bits needed to represent certain information. Lossless compression is a class of data compression algorithm that allows the original data to be perfectly reconstructed from the compressed data. Therefore, here the chance of the data reduction is less as compared to the next one is lossy compression. If the compression and decompression process induce some information loss, then the compression scheme is called as lossy compression. Therefore, here the most of the large amount of data will be the reduced in compared with the lossless compression. Now we see compression ratio. The compression ratio is defined as ratio of the B0 by B1, that is represented by the equation number 1, where B0 is the number of bits before the compression and B1 represents the number of bits after the compression. Therefore, the compression ratio defined as ratio of the number of bits before compression to the number of bits after the compression. Now, basics of information theory. Now, before going to this information, basic information theory, we want to go for what is the means of entropy. Entropy N of an information source with alphabet, yes, there is a different sample space. Here we take as a N sample space, that is S1, S2, S3 up to Sn. And from this sample space, we can derive the formula for entropy. N is equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to n, Pi log to the base 2, 1 by Pi, that is equation number 2. Now, this 1 by pi goes to the numerator. When it will goes to the numerator, then it will become as a minus. Therefore, this equation 2 become as minus summation I is equal to 1 is to n pi log to the base 2 pi, that is equation number 3. This is a formula for the entropy, where pi is the probability that symbol si in S will occur. The next term, that is log base 2 1 by pi, indicates the amount of information contained in SI, which corresponds to the number of bits needed to encode SI. Now we see variable length coding. The entropy indicates the information contained in an information source, that is S. It leads to a family of coding methods commonly known as entropy coding methods. Variable length coding is one of the best known such methods. Now we want to see Shannon-Fano algorithm. The Shannon-Fano algorithm was implemented, developed by Shannon at the Bell Labs and Robert Fano at MIT. Therefore, the name indicates Shannon-Fano. The encoding steps of the Shannon-Fano algorithm can be presented in the following top-down manner. There are basically two steps. From first step is sort the symbol according to the frequency count of. Now, second one is recursively divide the symbols into two parts, each with approximately the same number of counts until all parts contain only one symbol. Now we want to see a natural way of implementing the above procedure is to build a binary tree. As a convention, let's assign bit 0 to the left branch, bit 1 to the right branch. It's a method of constructing perfect code based on a set of symbols and their probabilities estimated or measured. The technique was proposed in Shannon's A Mathematical Theory of Communication, his 1948 article introducing the field of information theory. In the field of data compression, Shannon-Fano coding named after Claudie Shannon and Robert Fano. Now you want to see the example. Symbols to be coded are the characters in the word is a speaker. And first of all, we want to calculate the frequency count of the symbol is. Here, for the S, how many times it will comes? If you observe, S is comes to 1. Therefore, you write here, S is 1. P comes 1. Here, E comes 2 times. In the here and here. Therefore, we write here, E is a 2. A occurs 1 time. K occurs 1. R occurs 1. Therefore, if you made summation of this one, we get total number is 7. Now, everyone pause the video here and recall the first step of the Shannon-Fano algorithm. Okay. Now, the first step is sort the symbol according to the frequency count of their occurrence. Therefore, the previous table become as largest number, the count of symbol become first, and after that one, it will arrange in this way descending order. Therefore, the previous table become now this one. Now, steps 2. Recursively divide the symbols into two parts, each with approximately the same number of counts until all parts contains only one symbol. Now, if you observe here, I want to divide it into two main parts nearly equal. Therefore, I want to divide left hand side. I will get ES, that is a total number of counts is 2 plus 1 is a 3. Therefore, I am writing here 3. And if you observe remaining part PAKR, that total becomes 4. That's I will take is the right hand side. It will PAKR. And left hand side indicates 0 and right hand side indicates 1. Again, in the next step, I want to divide this part. Again, I want to divide this part until that now contains only one part. Therefore, now the next becomes this ES is divided into two parts. That is E, that is 2. That is a count of symbol is 2. Again, S I divide 1. Again, if I divide, this is a nearly equal parts, that is PA2, KR2. Again, I want to divide these parts because it does not contains a single symbol, it contains double. That's why again I want to divide this one. Here I am not required to divide these parts. Therefore, the next part become as PA2 is divided into 1 and A is a 1. KR is divided into K1 and R1. In this way, I will divide up to the this contains the single. Now next, if you observe this part, I made one table that is the first column indicates symbol, after that one count and code. Now if you observe, this table is calculated from this diagram. Now if you observe here, these are the symbols and these are the counts which I was done in the previous slide. Now if this code becomes as, if you observe E from this one, E comes from 0, 0. That's why here I will write 0, 0. S comes, if you observe, S comes 0, 1, that I want to write 0, 1. In this way, I will write all this code for these different symbols. Now, I want to calculate the number of bits used. Number of bits is used calculated with the help of code into count. Code here, these are the 2 and this is 2. 2 into 2, 4. In this way, you have to count the number of bits used. If you observe here code is 2. And here count is 1. This 2 how it will comes? 0 and 1. There are 2 symbols. That's why you have to take as a 2. 2 into 1, that is a 2. And in this way, I will use the number of bits used. Now I want to calculate the probability. How we calculate the probability? I will calculate the probability by count divided by the number of count. That is 2 by 7. I will get 0.29. In this way, I will count for the different symbols. Now here, the total number of bits is the summation of this all this total number of bits, that is here 18 bits. Now I want to go for compression ratio. If the total number of bits required to represent the data before compression is B0, the total number of bits required to represent the data after the compression is B1. Therefore, compression ratio is B0 by B1. Here, for B0 is equal to 8 into 7 is equal to 56 symbols. Here there are 7 characters, and for each character I will take as 8 bits. B1 is a total 18 bits that we calculated in the previous slide. Therefore, the compression ratio becomes 3.11. Therefore, average number of bits used by 7 symbols is 2.57. Now, entropy. Now, entropy I will calculate it from this table as the formulas 0.29 into log to the base 2, 1 by 0.29 plus 0.14. That's remaining, all this part contains the same. That's why I will multiply it by the 5, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's why I will write the 5. After this, following these steps, we get the value is 2.52. This suggests that minimum average number of bits to code each character in the world speaker would be at least 2.52. The Shannon-Fano algorithm delivers satisfactory coding results for data compression. The references for this topic is... Thank you.